这样一个非常好的一个环境当中举办我们的这场文化盛宴。今天主办方呢为我们做了非常充分的准备，然后在接下来的交流环节也有很多的小惊喜啊。我们是希望能够为大家打造一个轻松活泼的环境，希望大家能够。
To deliver a speech related to Thai culture and uniqueness. I would like to note that Thai government now put priority on the oversight of culture, religions, and arts. The Ministry of Culture is responsible for this mission and has a great attempt to foster pride of Thai identity. Therefore, nowadays, the ministry carries forward to promote the development of creative industry. The first one is fighting or Thai boxing. As of now, this kind of local authentic martial arts could generate great incomes and fame to the country. Second is about festival. Thailand has lots of festivals. Apart from Songkran and festival related to Buddhism, this ceremony reflects that Thailand is the land of prosperous culture, identity, and uniqueness. The third is about fashions. Thai silk and fabric is gorgeous and could be contemporary.
I'm Joan Michelle, speaking on behalf of the Indonesian delegates, would like to thank to All China Youth Federation and China National Center for Cultural Studies for organizing Asian Youth Culture Workshop today. It's an honor for me and Indonesian delegates to join this program today in Beijing.
China is the largest archipelago country in the world, consisting of 70,500 population islands with a population of nearly 270 million people. Indonesia also is the largest Muslim country in the world, with more than 230 million people. Besides having a densely populated population and large area, Indonesia has a natural area that supports the second largest biological diversity in the world. Indonesia consisting of 34 provinces with a total of 1,300 ethnic groups, with the largest numbers are Javanese, Sundanese, Batak, Sulawesi, and Madura. In Indonesia, there are six religions that are recognized. Muslims with the highest adherence, and following by Christian, Protestant, Catholics, Hindus, Buddhists, and Confucians. And for languages, there are more than 1,000 regional languages, but still united in one national language, which is Bahasa. The uniqueness of Indonesia is that although there are very diverse differences, both in terms of ethnicity, language, and religion, Indonesia has the main principle of unity in Indonesia.
As found in the basic ideology of the Indonesian state, namely Pancasila, on the third principle, which is the unity of Indonesia. Besides that, the similar idea also found in Bhinneka Tunggal Ika, which is the motto or slogan of the Indonesian nation. This is praise comes from the old Javanese language. It's an excerpt from ancient Javanese book namely Sutta Soma book, written by Empu Tantular during the Majapahit kingdom around 14th century. The atmosphere of harmonious religious life in heterogeneous community with a various religious background is built on tolerance that respects differences. Various socio-cultural activities characterized by mutual cooperation of an Indonesian community that respects various groups, ethnicity, and religions. Therefore, all religious holidays has been ratified as Indonesian national holidays. In addition, one example that occurred in Indonesia, especially in the province of Bali, in the Nyepi religious day, all activities were dismissed for 24 hours, starting from electricity, internet access, business activity, including airport, in order to respect the majority of the populations and uphold tolerance among the people. From this point, I hope we can learn something about the unity and diversity in Indonesia and strengthen our relationship between countries as one Asian big family. Terima kasih. Thank you. 谢谢.